Hello folks, and welcome to another landing tutorial for Microsoft Flight Simulator. Today, we're going to take a look at a rare but iconic approach to Osaka Itami International Airport in Japan, nicknamed Gyaku Run, which translates as reverse run, or more commonly, Itami Turn. The vast majority of airline flights lands at runway 32 left. That's a rather uneventful approach besides the fact that it includes a very scenic descent over the city. Yet, approximately 3% of flights have to land on runway 14 right due to wind from the southeast. Considering that you can't approach runway 14 right straight in due to the presence of a little rain, you have to perform a downwind leg parallel to the runway, followed by a fully visual 180 degrees turn right before touchdown. As usual, do keep in mind that what I'm about to show you is only for entertainment purposes in home flight simulators. I am not a professional pilot or instructor, and the content of this video is not to be used for training or real-world flight. I'm using the development version of the A321X Airbus A320neo by Fly-by-Wire, and the airport scenery is by Metropolitan Airport Development Brothers, but you'll need an additional free announcement mod by Karuchi on flightsim.to to add crucial elements like the lead-in lightning system. A list of the mods used will be included in the video's description, alongside a link to my journalistic Microsoft Flight Simulator coverage on TwinFinite. This approach is so rare that there is precious little information online on how it's performed, so this video is based on tidbits I could find online, observation of several real-life videos, and hints from the charts. I don't claim it's the correct way of doing it, but it's how it works for me, and should be reasonably close. Let's take a look at the charts. You need to set up for the ILS approach on runway 32 left, and you need to be at 3500 feet by waypoint Ikoma. Your minimum for the circling approach is 610 feet. You'll notice I'm setting the speed manually starting with 210 knots in order to keep things moving smoothly, as manager mode will slow you down way more than you need. In this second chart, you can see the leading approach lights northwest of the airport. As you complete the turn toward Ikoma, you can prepare for the ILS approach. Incidentally, you can see Yao Airport below us. It's one of the most relevant general aviation airports in Japan. After Ikoma, you can engage approach mode and set 200 knots before you select flaps 1.
2500.
Flaps 1. Approach mode engaged. We have intercepted the localizer. Let's engage track FPA mode. In front of us, you can see Osaka Castle and the beautiful skyline of the city. We have intercepted the glide slope and started our descent. But don't relax yet, this is where the workload starts to increase. As you pass Osaka Castle on your left, manually select 295 degrees heading and pull the knob to leave the ILS. Then quickly reduce the flight path angle to 0.5 degrees. The procedure is required to fly this part as high as you can, so a very shallow descent is advised. While I forgot, at this point you should also set the altitude back to 5000 feet for a possible go around, but do not pull on the knob. It's worth mentioning that smaller aircraft could turn right here instead, but jets are forbidden from doing so and must fly the downwind leg southwest of the airport. At this point, you can take a moment to enjoy the view of Osaka's seafront Minato Ward and Universal Studios Japan. Beyond the bay, you can see the city of Kobe and its offshore airport. As you fly over the Yodo River, you can turn parallel to the runway to heading 322 degrees for your downwind leg. Then, you need to slow down to 160 knots. Ping the cabin for landing, arm the spoilers, and set auto brakes to low. It's a fairly long runway, so you don't need more. You will see the first leading approach lights flashing in front of you on the banks of the Muko River. You may need to adjust your heading a bit here, making sure to fly over the lights. Flaps 2. It's time to select managed mode for the speed and lower your landing gear. The landing gear is down and locked, so turn on the taxi lights and the turn-off lights. Flaps 3. Flaps full. Disengage the autopilot, and at this point you should also select 142 degrees runway track heading for a possible go-around, even if I forgot to do it. Start turning right following the flashing lights and descend approximately by 600-700 feet per minute. Your goal is to end the turn at approximately 610 feet, which is your minimum. Keep flying over the leading approach lights until you see the runway. When you have the runway in sight, if you've done everything correctly, you'll have two white lights and two red ones on the puppy. If you don't, apply the required corrections, compensate for potential crosswind, level your wings on the 142 track, and prepare to land.
400. $300. $200. $100. $50. $40. $30. $20. Retard. $10. $5.
We have landed. Welcome to Osaka Itamiya Airport. I hope this tutorial has been enjoyable and useful to you. If you enjoyed it, please leave a like and subscribe, and I'd appreciate it a lot if you could follow my Microsoft Flight Simulator news and review coverage on Twinfinite, link in the description. Now, I'll leave you with the replay.
The door is very fast.